Hello, and welcome to another video from Aid Data. Today, we'll look at different ways organizations use geospatial or location-based data, from creating maps to tracking projects on the ground. One example is EcoPotential, a European-funded project that used geospatial data to analyze the impact of human development on biodiversity in Israel. Another example is how the UN and the WHO are using geospatial data to measure progress on clean water, the sixth Sustainable Development Goal. Multiple geospatial datasets can even be used for a single project. The Institute of Health Metrics and Evaluation, IHME, joined various datasets from a number of African countries to pinpoint where child malnutrition was worst. IHME combined data on many subjects, such as health surveys, agricultural and weather reports, light pollution, and even war zones, into a single map to track how each country was doing on achieving the WHO's global nutritional targets for 2025. With this data, researchers were able to discover uneven progress in Zambia. While there were areas of significant growth and improvement, there were other areas with little to none. With this insight, Zambia can adjust accordingly to reach the nutritional targets by 2025. Using geospatial data helps organizations and governments solve problems and make better, more evidence-based decisions. But what if you're just getting started and don't know where to find easy-to-use geospatial data? AidData's GeoQuery tool can help. We curated over 65 open-source datasets on the environment, health, conflict, human development, and more. GeoQuery also saves you time by performing spatial statistics calculations that would otherwise need to be done by code or specialized software. Visit aiddata.org/geoquery to get started.